the gadool and the chickaboola, a bibbidi bobbidi.
Oh my god, did I just get a brand new gi? Look at this gorgeous bad boy. It even matches my purple belt, although, let's be honest, I'm not purple for too much longer. Now you're thinking, I bet yeah, she has so many gis and too many gis and probably does not need a new gi, but let's have a look at this. You be the judge of this. Now, I really have not wanted to retire my gi because I love my Shiro gi that I've had for about 7-8 years now, but I think it's about time I've retired this bad boy. Take a look at this lapel, this collar. It's not even a proper white collar anymore. It has definitely had its day. But I'm gonna miss it, but it's okay. I have upgraded and I've decided this time I'm gonna go for a black gi. And this is what I'm now dealing with. So let's go try this bad boy out, eh? Happy and healthy people, Tia Marks here, and in this video I'm going to give you guys 5 things that you need to think about before buying a brand new gi, and that's because guess what, I finally got a new gi. Every single day I'm gonna make... Okay, number one is the weather. You need to make sure you're buying the gi for the place that you live. Now here in Australia, it has been humid as crazy and it is summer here. Now even our winter here in Queensland is not really winter. We go to like 10 degrees in the middle of the day and then maybe like a 3 to 6 in the evening if we're kind of lucky. But generally you don't really need a thick gi in Australia. You can pretty much get away with wearing like a long sleeve something underneath your gi if you are a little bit cold. But make sure you buy the gi appropriate for where you live. I know so many people come to the mat with these gorgeous brand new gis that are so thick and they are suffocating. So make sure you look online at reviews and actually find out what the weight is of the gi and what the thickness is, and if it's actually appropriate for the weather and the place that you are at. Number two is the sizing. Make sure you know your size well and actually look at the sizing graph and measure. Now, a lot of the sizing graphs now actually have height and weight recommendations, which is epic, but gi sizes do change quite a bit. Now, the last 3 or 4 gis I've bought have all been female standard gis, and I've realized the hard way that my legs are not female standard. The female standard is usually like an A1F or an A2F. It usually has an F at the end for female. And the legs on these pants are usually like skinny jeans. They are skin tight and there is no room. I don't know who assumes that females do not have legs and glutes that do jiu-jitsu, but for some reason, any female gi seems to not fit my legs and my glutes very well. So for the first time, I've actually bought a male gi. Now I went up in the size, I went an A2, which is a pretty big gi. And the reason for that is because the A2 pants are gonna fit me perfectly. Now all I'm gonna have to do is shrink at the A1 gi jacket. So it requires a little bit more washing and a little bit of dryer time, but hopefully I can shrink it to fit me perfectly. Number three is the color. Now your gym might be one of those gyms that you require to have a certain color, or you might go visit certain gyms that require this. Some competitions and even some like seminars tell everyone to wear the exact same color gi. Now, I recommend sticking to the blues, the blacks, and the whites for at least having one gi that fit those colors. You can have your funky pink or your funky dark blue or your funky weird navy color if you wish, but make sure you have at least one color standard gi, because one, you can't actually compete in a funky color gi, and two, you're always going to come across something that requires you to wear a white gi. So the bare minimum, everyone should own at least one white gi, and then you can add in some funky colors on top of that. But if you are going to be doing this for a while, you will start to accumulate more gi colors. Now, one thing you should mention about colored gis is a lot of colors show sweat. And I know that's not a problem, but as a female, the last thing you want is to have like showing that you're sweating through your pants or through your back or through your arms. Like, you just don't want to be seeing sweat stains through your gi. So I do have a War Tribe gi, which is really gorgeous, and I'll show it to you, and the sweat does show quite a bit through it, so it makes me a little bit uncomfortable to wear in the middle of summer. Look at this gi, it is stunning, but the color shows sweat straight away. The fabric and quality is amazing, and yes, it was an A1F. It was a woman's gi, so the pants are not gonna work for me, so I have to wear white pants with it, so I look absolutely ridiculous on the mats, and everyone's like, that does not match, because it's hard to find a color like this to get matching pants that are going to fit me. But this color on the mat when you sweat through it is not as pretty as the gi looks. The fourth thing to keep in mind is when you're buying a new gi is how often do you actually use your gi? Do you do more no gi, and do you do a lot of gi? Do you really need to spend a lot of money on a gi? Now, I own two Shirol gis. One I've had for about 8 years. The other one I've worn twice because it is so thick and uncomfortable, and the pants don't fit properly, and it's just not the perfect fit gi for me, so it sits in my cupboard accumulating dust. And yeah, I have a brand new gi that's a bit less than $100 and it fits perfect, and it's probably going to be used until it dies. Now, my other War Tribe gi, I spent about $200-$300 on as well, and I probably wore it about 10 times because the color wasn't really what I wanted. So I don't recommend going out and buying a really expensive gi, because one, you're going to have a bunch of gis, you don't actually know what's going to work perfect for you. Once you find a brand that you love, it's easy to kind of just buy for in that brand. But if you're like me and you have a unique body shape, it's really hard to find the perfect gi, so you are just going to bounce from gi to gi until you find the gi that works best for you. And number five, when you get a brand new gi, you have to be patient. You have to wear the hell out of this thing to make it a lot less stiff and a lot smoother, and so you feel comfortable in it. Now, never buy a new gi for competition, because that gi is going to be stiff and uncomfortable and non-stretchy as hell. So I recommend, when you get a new gi, understand that you're going to be very uncomfortable for your first few classes. You're going to feel stiff, you're going to feel tight, everything's going to feel stuck. I recommend giving your gi a good wash before you wear it once. It might help move it around a little bit. Try and stretch it out if you can. But the first time you wear that gi, in the first few times, could be weeks, could be months until it's fully worn in, it's going to feel not nearly as good as your old gi that you fully just like molded into your body. Thanks guys so much for checking out my video. I hope that you guys got a little bit out of this, but if there's something I missed that I should know before purchasing the new gi, let me know in the comments below. But I'm absolutely loving my brand new purple gi. I did it on the mat today. I felt a little bit stiff at the start of training when we were drilling, and as soon as I started moving, I was like, oh my God, I can feel this is a brand new gi. But as soon as I started rolling, I actually did not notice. And I thought that was gonna be worried that the gi jacket felt a little bit big. I had put it in the dryer again, but I actually didn't even notice in my rolling that it felt big. It actually felt pretty perfect. So it actually felt really fine, and I could breathe really well in it. So I was quite happy with my brand new gi. But thank you guys for watching my video. I'm actually going to post a fair few of my rolls. I've been videoing a lot of my rolls so I can start critiquing them, so I can start looking at them and seeing where I'm messing up. So I might actually start posting them on my YouTube and let you guys kind of watch them and let me know what I'm doing wrong as well. And maybe you guys could give me some pointers and tips. Like, there's so many people out there that are much better at this sport than I am, and maybe I can get a little bit of a help from you guys. So thank you again for watching my video. Press the big red subscribe buttons that are hanging out somewhere up there. And in the meantime, keep being strong, happy, and healthy. On a weird side note, if I'm kind of mumbling in this video, I really apologize. I did do jiu-jitsu at lunchtime, and it is so hard to talk and get through the day when I do lunchtime jiu-jitsu, because my body is so tired, and even my mouth is too tired to talk. So if you can't understand anything I say, let me know and I'll try and translate for you.